Shaping my GSD as much as possible in prep for the much anticipated Wisconsin seminar. Looking forward to this experience. Ken,
don't put too much pressure on yourself. If you bring me a dog that's too well trained, I'll be like, you're wasting your money to bring the dog. Don't be shaping any fucking behaviors. Don't worry about that. This isn't a test. Ken, it's not a test. There's no grading.
That's how I felt, though, bringing Wes. I'm like, you better be on your best behavior.
That's because you're fucked up. Okay?
I was so nervous.
I don't know why.
I didn't want him to look bad.
But why would you be there? I don't know. It's ridiculous. It's not a test. You're not there to you're not there to impress me. I'm there to help you with your problems. Like most dogs that come there are really struggling. Mm-hmm. That's my job. I'm there to help people. But if you practice as much as you want, I mean, you got to do something. It's still, a couple months away. So looking forward to see you too. And if anyone's wondering about seminars, I do about 24, 25 a year. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. I do them all around the world this year so far, just in North America, Canada, and the United States. Next. Hey, we're live, everybody. Hey, everybody. How are you doing? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How's everything? Big shout out, Wildcraft Knives. Big shout out to them.
Oh my God. Stood up to do that.
Well, they can't see it. Like I said.
I'm sorry. I can't.
Like I said, turn off the volume.
Happens every time.
My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is a Q&A show that I do three times a week. We did it last night and tonight because I was traveling. And then tomorrow morning, 4:30 a.m., I head out down to New Orleans to pick up my new RV. I'm driving back, so there won't be a show for a couple more days. But after that, we'll be in the regular swing of things. Like for the next 8 months.
Yeah.
For the next 8 months, we'll be in the regular swing of things. People tend to be drawn to this show because they want problem solved. So I'm a dog trainer, business owner in Providence, Rhode Island. We specialize in aggression rehab, behavior modification. We work with a lot of challenging dogs. In fact, if you want to see more of our videos, we put up about a dozen at least videos a week just on YouTube, probably a couple dozen on Facebook and on Instagram, lots of informative posts. But this channel, hit subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified when we put uploads up. We're going to use the word punishment a lot. Punishment, people turn it as a negative, but there's actually a proper way to correct a dog, and that's the proper application of punishment. The thing about punishment is you're not mad, you're not angry, you're not upset. We utilize lots of training tools. The thing is the lack of training tools, what happens is people use more anger. You know you do, like you yell at your dog or you're pissed off, but you know, which... So having training tools is great. You don't have to do any of that stuff. You can be nice and calm and have a conversation with your dog. And the dog learns. So we use that word a lot tonight because you're going to see most people want me to stop something. Hey, Jeff, how do I stop fill in the blank? So you'll notice that. Obviously, we train dogs on obedience. We actually use clickers and food to do that. So there's also something called Top Chat right by where it says say something where you can type in your question. There's a dollar sign. The dollar sign is something that YouTube has put in place for creators like ourselves that put out massive amounts of free content, a lot of helpful stuff. Some people would just like to throw a little bit of cash our way, but other folks, they want to go to the top of the queue. I think yesterday we had about 50 questions we couldn't even get to. There's a ton of questions we couldn't even get to. I talk a lot. But also we have a Patreon channel, which you can join and you can participate in that. And then obviously I do Skypes. Most people that come here actually need a Skype. So, but there's a fee for that. So, but this is all free. So ask your questions, get your answers. Here we go.
Tropical Tales. Hey, it's me, Bitless Equestrian. Just changed my username. How's it going?
Why are you changing your username?
She also said she's getting a new puppy soon, but couldn't do it without you guys.
Awesome. Super proud of you.
Love. I know it's going to be weird not saying Bitless
Equestrian. I know it's going to be really Tropical Tales. Did you put that out to vote? Did anybody vote on that? Was there a vote?
Change it back.
Next.
Jess, my 2-year-old GSD is mouthing and growling at our 11-year-old Pomeranian. Mm-hmm. Used collar on GSD. She stopped, but the Pom starts this aggressive encounter by growling and snapping at the GSD, and the GSD will retaliate.
No shit.
We've come a long way since their intro 2 weeks ago. Using Bonker on the Pom to stop growling, she attacks it, tried our pet spy, M686 shock collar for barking palm. Doesn't seem to feel it.
Fuck the 686.
And it's almost maxed, so not sure it'll work for growling. Palm has history of aggression to humans and dogs, but no instances since I've had her.
And you, when you brought a new dog in? Okay, listen to me. First of all, the Pomeranian's being a pain in the ass, and it's going to end up as fucking lunch real soon. You need to advocate for all with both dogs. So chances are it sounds like it is the Pomeranian might be the instigator. All I know is this. I don't know what crap e-collar you have now, but get yourself a it's a Pomeranian. Get yourself a what do they call them? The macros?
Micro.
Get a micro e-collar technology one. Micro e-collar technology. Get one of those. Make sure it's fitted properly. All growling and snapping. You're correct. Stop the bad behavior, then train what you want. But that dog's going to end up as lunch. If that Pomeranian growled and barked at my dogs aren't just going to sit there and go, what's with the attitude, you little Pomeranian? No, they're dogs. They're dogs. So advocate for both.
Top chat.
Top chat, Canadian 699. Hey, Michelle. Dogs with separation anxiety much better and crate using your methods. During the day, she still pants, won't sleep, stress yawns. Fuck stress yawning. I stress yawn. Nobody's helping me, okay? Who gives a shit about stress yawning, okay? I never want to hear about stress yawning and licking lips and all that nonsense. Don't worry about the stress yawn. Life is stressful. Welcome to the world, right? How do I get her to fully relax in the crate? Massive amounts of duration when the dog's not in the crate as well. Watch her chit-chat. Most people over-talk to their dogs. They talk way too much to their dogs. And then hold the dog accountable for nonsense. So there's a lot of ways you can do a lot of relaxation stuff without, like, you don't need medication, please. But having that dog learn downstay with a head down, that's very helpful. Duration work, it's very helpful. But don't just do it when you leave the house. Do it whenever you're in the house. Because the dog, you know, teach that dog how to relax. But I don't want to hear about the stress yawning anymore. Don't want to hear about it. Next.
Victoria. Hey, Jeff. Thanks for your 180 video. In constant practice, my bully pit bull is doing much better on walks. There is a toy that my four-year-old has that freaks him out. It is the only thing that makes him break place. What do I do to stop this without taking the toy away from my kid? It's loud, but son has never done anything to cause the dog to be fearful. He tucks his tail and runs behind me every time my son has it. My other dog could care less about it. She stays and plays, no problem.
Okay.
By the way, he doesn't care if he gets bonked in this scenario. It is literally back and forth, over and over until the son puts it away.
Okay, so this is the thing. First of all, I remember what I wanted to mention is if your Pomeranian is playing with the bonker, you didn't bonk properly. Guys, your dog shouldn't want to play with a bonker. A bonker is a cotton towel. This is a cotton towel. The last thing your dog should do, and I've got a video on how to use it and how to make it. The last thing your dog should do is want to play with it. That means you're tossing it to the dog. It should be thrown at the dog very firmly. And I know the conversation out there. Oh my God, you're hitting your dog. Whatever. Okay. Dogs are dying. So what I want you to do is that when you're bonking. Number two. It doesn't make, just because the dog hasn't done anything to the, dogs aren't afraid of things that something's been done harmful to them. So like we have dogs that when they go outside and a plastic bag goes by, they tuck their tail and hide. Does that mean that someone tried to like, you know, put a plastic bag over their head and suffocate them or tie their legs up with a plastic bag? No, they're not connected. The fear is just this thing that dogs have. So do humans. So one of my daughters is definitely afraid of this tiniest spider. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. But it's fear. It's like, it's not like a spider ever bit her and she saw a scary movie with a spider. Why? Who knows why? All I know is you're usually not born with fear. It's a learned behavior. So with your dog now, put your dog in place. Put your dog in a down, hold your dog accountable, start with the toy far away, move the toy in. Hold the dog accountable to the obedience command, and that's what we do, and the dog won't give a shit about their damn toy. But if it's one of those annoying little toys that I'm thinking about, man, I'd be pissed off too. But that's how you stop it. Next.
Sebastian. Four-year-old heeler mix goes nuts when given pressure to correct after breaking a down stay. I use a prong, by the way. In our last session, she shut down and refused to respond to any pressure, treats, or praise. Is it just her working through it, or is there something I may have done?
Okay. I don't know your skill set. I don't know the dog. When you talk about pressure, like if a dog knows the command, it should be a pop, not continuous pressure. If a dog knows the command, but the dog most likely didn't shut down. The dog just probably just decided not to move. It's really hard to shut down a dog. But dogs that are a lot of nervous and fearful, well, first of all, there should be no praise whatsoever involved because the dog's not doing what you want. Food, most dogs that are nervous won't take food. So take food, and by the way, we food train guys, so take food out of the equation, take praise and physical touch out of the equation, and get the dog to go back into a down. That's all that should matter. But if you're doing slow pressure on a dog that already knows the command, you're most likely, it should be a firm correction. Next.
Laura, this morning, an aggressive dog from the house, ours, jumped an 8-foot wall fence. Their yard is lower than ours, whilst boss was trying to take a shit. I called him inside right away, but he was extremely startled and defensive. Any tips to help him be confident outside again? I'm already planning on putting up a higher fence.
I would also carry a gun, you know, and I would also have a talk with your neighbor. So yeah, just put your dog on a leash and take him outside. So that's what I would do. But you shouldn't put up a higher fence. Your neighbor should contain their dog. And I'm serious. If a dog jumped a fence and like charged me, it wouldn't be pretty. Next.
Pichu, hi, good evening. I'm sleepy, so probably going to bed early tonight. It's 10 p.m. here.
Ooh, yeah, and what's your point? 10 p.m.? Okay.
Like, yeah, that's the time I go to bed.
That's 2 more hours of freaking work time.
It's 10 p.m. there.
I can read.
Igor returned home today. He was recovering of his neuter on the school. Tomorrow we go back to training.
Awesome. Thanks, Pichu.
Melissa says hi.
Good night, Pichu. Yep.
Hey, Melissa.
Hey, Melissa.
Lakey, what age can I put a prong collar on a puppy?
Depends on the breed, the size. I mean, a 14-week-old dog can have you can start conditioning the dog to the prong, but we don't really use it for much at that age. It's all food and marker training at that age. But getting the dog used to the pressure, you can usually start it at 12 or 14 weeks old. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey.
Hey, Michelle. Brooke. Hi, Jeff. Brooke from the recent T3. Thanks again for everything you do.
Brooke, it was fantastic meeting you. Congratulations. Glad you were there. It's an awesome week.
Sarah, I was correcting with Prong for noncompliance when he barked at me. I corrected and he went to bite me, but didn't seem intent. How can I work with my dog so he won't redirect?
Again, Sarah, there's a lot. I don't know your skill set. I don't know your skill set at all. Those are all objections. A lot of people are saying, oh, that's because prongs make dogs aggressive. No, they don't. No, they don't. So you can always muzzle the dog up. But what were you correcting for, too? What were you correcting for? But the fact, non-compliance. Okay, so the thing is, does the dog know the command? How well does the dog know command? But the fact that the dog's barking at you is just a big objection. We have dogs that do that, too. We work them through it. We work them through it. Next.
Aaron, need to work on known commands in public places, heel place. Should I use kibble or just e-collar and prong? Went to pet store for the first time since training 3 months ago, pulling, breaking down.
So the dog might not be ready for that. So I don't know. So in public, sometimes food is impractical because there's a lot to worry about. And sometimes dogs get really nervous and they won't take food. But the fact that I would start by walking your dog in busy places. The pet store can be overwhelming for some dogs, can be overwhelming. The fact that the dog was pulling tells me that you need to still work on your leash handling skills and your basic obedience. So what I would do is I would make sure that your dog is actually heeling next to you and you're not just holding your dog back. So make sure your dog understands heel. And then maybe don't go inside somewhere, go like on exterior of buildings, go through crowded parking lots. Go to areas where there's people so you can utilize space if you need to. But the pet store might just be overloading your dog. Next.
Sarah, I corrected when he went to bite, just wondering how to prevent. Oh wait, I already read that, right? Yep. Jack, 9-month-old puppy holds place for multiple hours, but is squirmy, doesn't settle in place sometimes. Just keep practicing and don't correct unless whining or breaking command.
If first of all, that's impressive for a couple hours. If I had a 9-month-old dog that definitely knew place and he was being squirmy on place, I mean, I guess we have to define what squirmy is, but at some point I probably would correct that because that's a choice. That's a choice. And place is, it's like, it's not just physically being in place. It's also mentally being in place. And the dog's not in a relaxed state when it's doing that. So at some point I would correct. I would correct. Next.
Sandy. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Sandy.
Jackie. Hi, Jeff. Asked yesterday about correcting fence jumping. Would you correct as soon as the dog takes off running or wait until he's right at the fence line? Also, how should I react after giving a correction?
Good night, Angelo.
Good night, Angelo. I get hugs first.
Good choice. Good choice, Angelo. Smart move, buddy.
Good night, buddy.
I love you.
See you Friday. You're going to help us train dogs?
Mm-hmm. I'm not going to see you tomorrow. I'll be gone already. Bye, Mom. All right. Love you.
Love you too. Bye.
Bye. The first time you correct for fence jumping, you wait till they get right to the fence. You correct high. How should you react after? How should you react? No, you don't say anything. Like, there's no yelling. There's no screaming. You're not mad. You're not upset. You're fine. If the dog lets out an audible, which it might, you're trying to save its life by giving it a high correction for trying to jump the fence. I don't want to say no, don't feel bad, but I mean, you're saving your dog's life. You're saving your dog's life. So, the first time you do it, you wait till the dog pretty much gets right to the fence. Next.
Eliazi, shaping my GSD as much as possible in prep for the much anticipated Wisconsin seminar. Looking forward to this experience. Ken,
don't put too much pressure on yourself. If you bring me a dog that's too well trained, I'll be like, you're wasting your money to bring the dog. Don't be shaping any fucking behaviors. Don't worry about that. This isn't a test. Ken, it's not a test. There's no grading.
That's how I felt, though, bringing Wes. I'm like, you better be on your best behavior.
That's because you're fucked up. I know. Okay?
I was so nervous.
Well, I don't know why.
I didn't want him to look bad.
But why would you be there? I don't know. It's ridiculous. It's not a test. You're not there to, you're not there to impress me. I'm there to help you with your problems. Like, most dogs that come there are really struggling. Mm-hmm. That's my job. I'm there to help people. But if you practice as much as you want, I mean, you got to do something. It's still, a couple months away. So looking forward to see you too. And if anyone's wondering about seminars, I do about 24, 25 a year. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. I do them all around the world this year so far, just in North America, Canada, and the United States. Next.
Tammy, huge thanks for your channel. I'm looking forward to getting another couple dog and working on awesome things I've learned from y'all. So awesome.
Awesome, Tammy. Congratulations.
Jason, how can I teach my 14-month-old GSD to potty while on leash? It's been over 24 hours and he still hasn't peed. He just stays in a heel even when I tell him to break.
Well, that's not healthy for the dog. Well, what I would do is you stop, plant your feet, and like go to a grassy area. Well, first thing in the morning. How about the first thing in the morning? Dog usually has to go to the bathroom. Have it come and go outside. Go to a potty spot. What you can do is, this is what I do. Is it a guy or a girl? Jason.
Oh boy.
Piss on the ground. Really. Take it out. Drop trowel. Pee right on the ground. Don't get arrested because don't be throwing my name around. But
Jeff told me.
You pee on the ground. Bring the dog over to it. That's what you do. And no, you don't do that for poop. You don't do the same methodology for poop.
Elizabeth. What to do if a dog gets loose and runs up to me and my aggressive dog when we are out on a walk and that dog is also aggressive?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Elizabeth, I talk about loose dogs all the time and I talk about neutralizing the threat. This is sort of like a violent show tonight, isn't it?
Neutralize the threat.
It's like a violent show. Like, gosh, who's got puppies that want to be clicker trained? Come on, bring them on.
Bring them on down.
Bring them on down. Come on, help me out here, guys. You take out a fucking gun and shoot it. I mean, this is the thing. I mean, if you have a dog that's charging your dog with intent to harm or with serious intent, you have no choice, whether your dog is aggressive or not, to neutralize the threat. How do you neutralize the threat? By any means necessary. And it sounds really harsh, but oh my gosh, I could never kick another dog. I'm like, have you, I've seen dogs killed before by other dogs. And these aren't dog fights. This is like, it's horrific. I've seen pack attacks. I've seen dogs killed. I've seen dogs obviously bit. I've seen humans attacked. I've seen humans put down by dogs, multiple dogs attacking one human. I mean, guys, they're dogs. They don't give a shit. We have to remember, who's seen two cats fight before? You're like, Tabby? Is that you? It's incredible to watch two. Who's seen two cats fuck? I mean, it is incredible. It's incredible to see. All I know is this. For the amount of fucking noise they make outside my window, all right?
How many freaking stray cats do
you have? Like, Jesus Christ, I'm throwing 20s out the window. It's like, thanks for the show, guys. But no, I mean, animals can be horrific. Horrific. I mean, they are animals. They will fight to the death, some of these animals. So you got to do anything you possibly can. Carry a mace with you or bear spray. Carry a hiking stick with you. Anything. Next.
Shane, loving the pom-pom. Thanks for the peep show, Jeff. Is it my pom-pom?
Yes.
Thanks.
Yes.
Jacob, hi J&J. Just signed up for the Wisconsin seminar the other day.
Nice.
Super excited. Hoping to work on obedience and dog-dog interactions. Anything we should be boot camping to help have a productive seminar?
Yeah. Talk to.
Yeah. Right. You guys get a little club going.
Talk to Ken at Aliasi.
The pre-seminar seminar.
Talk to Ken at Aliasi. Make some friends. Get together every Friday. Have a little nosh, sit down, a little tea, and do some dog training. So when you come to my seminar,
you don't even need it.
We can just hang out and chit chat, do some photos, have a good time.
Oh, that sounds great.
Yeah,
sounds fun.
I want you to bring me your worst behaved dog. Is what I want. Make me work for my money. Make me work for my money. Next.
Mm-hmm. Holding on dog training. Hey Ashley. Working highly aroused dog, kennel work, bonker, long duration place, not aggressive, full speed ahead. Can't seem to get him to slow it down, making progress with him, but could food be the problem?
Yeah, if anything that's getting the dog aroused, verbal praise, physical touch, food, or toy, you need to take away. Leash on the dog, do real slow walks. Like, we're talking, like, real slow. Like, real slow, like your hemorrhoids are flaring up and it's hard to walk slow. Like, oh man, all right, do a slow walk. Ashley's the one that named two of her goats after one is named Joelle, and then she's
like, did you notice how my goat was like posing for the picture too?
Of course, like... of course. And that did you see the abs of that goat?
Yeah,
it was rock solid abs. All right. And then she's got a goat named Gellman. Did you notice how mine was picking up fucking change from the ground? Next.
He looked like he was about to tell a bad joke. That's right. Michelle Anderson.
Everybody walks around. That's the one that had the heart out all the time.
Oh my God. So inappropriate. Michelle, 6 months massive puppy.
Come on.
How do you stop using clicker for obedience training? This is my first dog clicker trained.
How do you stop using it or start using it?
How do you stop using clicker?
Transition to the word yes. Transition to the word yes. So we clicker train all dogs. So what we do is we clicker train the dogs. And then we get rid of the clicker. Like, owners don't go home with clickers. That's our job. Everyone's worried that shock collars are going to mess up dogs. Are hard to use. A clicker can be hard to use properly. Mm-hmm. So we transition. Once dogs understand the basic command, we transition them off of the clicker. We use the word yes. And then we eventually, we do variable rewarding on the food. And then we also then get rid of the food as well. And then when the dog knows the command, we hold them accountable with the proper application of punishment for the known commands. So that's what you're going to want to do. Good job, Michelle. Michelle, by the way, thanks for all the YouTube back and forth. I really appreciate your comments. I don't always respond, but I see every one of them. So thank you.
Brianna, hello. I have a 7-month-old ACD who is starting to show leash reactivity. He doesn't show reactivity when off leash and just generally works better off leash. How can I get him more confident on the leash?
That's why it's called leash reactivity. Yeah. So it's 7 months old?
Yes.
Yeah. So what you're doing now is you're it makes sense. So but that's what leash reactivity is. The leash is a barrier. So what I would do is your heel, make sure that you're giving your dog a really good proper heel. I don't know what the training tools you're using. I highly recommend a prong collar that'll help you be able to deliver the communication to your dog with right or wrong in a very effective, calm way. What most people do is they wait until the dog starts loading before they give the information, or they miss it and then they try to wrangle the dog back in. What you want to start doing is starting recognizing signs that the dog is aroused and going to load by looking at the dog, and you want to correct that state of mind. Next.
Jess, we had GSD prior to the Pomeranian. We inherited the Pomeranian. I'll be getting a new e-collar. Thank you.
Got it. Yeah. Well, you might not, you know, I would have this attitude. Hey, you little Pomeranian, you're on a freaking trial basis here. 30-day trial. All right. I'm housing you, feeding you, taking to the vet. You're making my life miserable. Like, I'll bust my ass for you, but let's get going here. Next.
Firm conversations. Melissa, my friend's dog will nip hard and bark when people move too quickly, are too loud, hug, dance, etc. Other than placement to manage her, what do you suggest?
Well, your friend should be contacting me, because now it's going to go through a third party here. What I would do is I would probably hire somebody. This is the safest thing. When company is over, the dog should be in a crate. That's not the answer, and that is management, but I don't want to be around that dog. I mean, as a guest, I don't want to be around that dog. I want to be able to dance, hug, walk fast, sit down, stand up, and not have a dog lunge at me. Right? So the responsible thing is to keep it away from guests right now. Don't use your guests as guinea pigs for if the dog's going to bite or not. Bottom line is, if the dog's in a down and it breaks it down, there's a correction. Dog's in place and it breaks place, there's a correction. There is going to be a management component to it. But you can't exactly ask your guests to like help proof that sometimes. So you put the dog on a tie back and a down, tie back in place, but the dog's not allowed to also get up or misbehave or bark or lunge or look like it's barking or lunging. You want the dog to be in a relaxed state. Crate the dog. So remember, I'm a family pet dog trainer. Sometimes we have to also do management, because we're talking to owners. Now I'm talking to the friend of the owner. So there's a lot that's going to get missed in that. But I would say get her to go start the rabbit hole of my free videos, you know? And at least, can that dog hold a downstay for an hour around fast moving things? That's a good start. If a dog goes to lunge, yes, there's a high level correction. Next.
Tammy, love the humor with the lessons. All caps.
Thanks, Tammy.
Shane, messaged yesterday about an Aussie doodle that has been unmotivated for 3 days and barely eating as a result, but woke up today a different dog. Thanks for all your help.
There we go. You were on last night's show. Yep. What?
All he had to do was ask the question.
Yeah, that's great. Yep. Nice job.
Sandy, hi, my dog bites the sitter. Help. She sits with her while we work.
So the house sitter goes there while you work. Okay, so I don't know the skill set of your sitter. I have no idea what your sitter is doing. Possibly hugging the dog, too much affection, too much freedom, not enough structure, no consequences. I have no idea what that sitter is doing. So I don't know. Most house sitters, pet sitters, they want to show lots of love and affection to the dog because they think that's what they were hired for. And that's not necessarily what it was. So, you know, why do you have a sitter? Is it a dog walker or a sitter? Did the dog come over? Is she walking the dog? Structured walk? So there's a lot of, I can't just give you an answer to that one because there's a lot of variables. I need to know what the context is, because there's no such thing as random, guys. Random does not exist in my world. There's always something. Next.
Crixis, what's up, Jeff and Joelle? Training is going great. Heel, place, and down. Distractions are still a problem. Ben slow and steady. Do you think I should push him harder?
Congratulations, by the way, for your progress. Not necessarily push the dog harder. Hold the dog more accountable now. Yes. Mm-hmm. Now it's probably time to application of a punisher for a known command, which, by the way, is the magic. You hear me say that a lot, guys, because that's the magic. If we don't hold dogs accountable for what they know, we're always going to get a half-ass behavior or dangerous behavior. Next.
Jay Wynn, when applying duration, example, 2 or 3 hours in play, should you reward during? Just curious.
I don't, but you could. So when my dogs are hanging out with me for 2, 3, 4 hours, what's the reward? They're hanging out with me. Some of you think that would be a punishment. You're like, Jeff, the last thing we want to do is hang out with you. I can't imagine that. I'd rather walk on broken glass. But my dogs, they like it. My dogs like it. So, but yeah, I have no problem with you just going some good and throwing it food, but you don't need to. You just don't need to. Next.
Bo Boatner, do you do spend think most pro trainers focus too much on why of dog behavior. I find it hard to buy that knowledge of wolf behavior has as much purpose as a certain pro trainer seems to think it does.
Well, I don't want to know who the trainers are. I can make a general, because I don't talk about trainers. Like, okay. Dog owners don't always care about the why. They just want it fixed. Now, there is a certain amount of why, but a lot of that stuff is just made up. It's made up to sound smart. Now, why does the dog bite like when I try to hug it? Because dogs don't like to be hugged. There's your why. When I'm walking my dog and all of a sudden it stops and lays down and doesn't move, why? Is it tired? It's not tired. Unhook the leash, the dog runs around like crazy. It's called an objection. I think, okay, if you're going to give the why, you better give the answer that works. How about that? So if someone's going to give you the why, that's really cool, but now what do I do? Because if you can't tell me what to do, I really don't give a shit why. Does that make sense? Next.
Next, Sebastian. Thanks for answering my question. I know exactly what to do next.
Good job, Sebastian. Never come on the show again. I don't remember the question.
Karen GSC lover. Hey, guys. My dog growls at me at intervals. I've corrected with e-collar last a few weeks. He licks his lips, hangs head prior to growling. Should I correct for those behaviors before he growls?
I'd have to see the video. If there's a precursor to growling, I'd like to know what's going on. We might not be able to get it on this show, but what's going on? Give me a situation. I mean, pretty much dogs should not be growling at humans, but if there's such an obvious precursor, what is it? What is it? But to answer the question is you would correct the intent. All right. You don't have to wait for the growl. You can correct the intent. Next.
Sandy should be trained with prong collar and clicker train. How?
Well, they two do different. Yeah. I mean, it's two different things. I mean, we clicker train dogs to
while they're on a prong.
So there's technically no such thing as prong collar training. The prong collar is a tool. You still got to do dog training, remote collar training. You still got to do dog training. The remote collar is just a communication tool. Like no dog is going to do a down, sit, place, recall, heel by pushing a button. You still got to train the dog or else the button doesn't mean anything. Same with the clicker. So it's just two different things. The clicker is just a marker that what they did was right, and then a reward's going to follow. Next.
Laura, I've missed your no-nonsense attitude. I was contemplating having to kick the dog if he went for boss, but nice to know my dog listens to me thanks to your advice. That's the dog that rushed her dog while it was pooping.
Oh, you would kick the dog. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Guys, protect your dogs. Protect your dogs. People get really weird. They get really weird about like I mind my business. I stay in my lane. But if I saw a dog fight, I'd have to be really careful about trying to intervene with it. Because the way you break up a dog fight is usually you choke the dog out. And somebody might get upset by that, but it's like, you do realize this dog's trying to kill that dog, right? Like people are really weird about stuff like that. So bottom line is, if an off-leash dog charges you, you have to stay safe. Next.
Ken, when do you fade transition from a prong collar to a flat collar, 13-month-old Ridgeback Brothers?
We don't. So I'm in no rush to stop using a prong collar on a dog. And I'm very aware of the conversation out there with trainers saying, well, then the dog's not trained. Fine, the dog's not trained. Who cares? If that's what you want, if that's the shaming story that a dog trainer wants to put on trainers and owners, well, then more power to them. All I know is this. You have to have a collar on the dog. First of all, who says a flat buckle collar is better than a prong collar? You have two 13-year-old Ridgebacks, which means 13-month-old Ridgebacks, which means they're probably siblings. you know, they're possibly going to be always working against each other. And any pressure on a dog's neck can cause damage where a prong collar is not. And I've seen the three photos that are published 10 million times, which is not from dog training, by the way. Look up embedded flat buckle collar. You'll be really disgusted. But the goal is not to get the dogs out of a flat buckle collar. The goal is to make your life easier. And if it takes a prong collar to make your life easier, so be it. So be it. It's all I really care about. Next.
Kevin. Hi, Jeff. Have a year and a half. Pit has no aggression with kids or other dogs. Has a great personality, but notice that he has bone aggression and growls. Do I take it away for good? Your thoughts? Thank you.
No, just do my resource guarding protocols are 3 seconds. We fix resource guarding in 3 seconds. Dogs are killed for it, and it's a 3-second fix. So it's all done with a remote collar. You utilize the out command, and I show it step by my seminars. I show it step by step, right in front of everybody. Boom, done. Yeah, teach them the out command. And yes, it's with a high level punisher, the remote. Yep, next.
Pichu, I don't really know. How do you survive on your day waking up so early? How many hours a day do you sleep?
Not enough. I know I've got sleep issues. I get 4 to 5 hours of sleep. Ideally, I can probably run on 6. I know I'm not getting enough sleep. I've cut down dramatically on my coffee. My fit, I've lost 25 pounds, not from lack of sleep. I'm getting into really good shape. I'm eating very extremely healthy. My mind is always going. I don't relax properly. Yes, my blood pressure has been high, but that's under control now. I don't know how I do it. It's probably not good for me. I get it. I'm aware. Next question. I'm not mad either.
Mike, hey guys, Patreon video is not up. Only the new Q and N is.
Really?
Q and N or Q and A?
Q and A. Really, Mike? I'll look at that. Make sure I look at that tonight. I loaded it up. I remember the link going up and everything. Maybe I didn't press Maybe. Publish.
Yeah.
Maybe I didn't press publish. Shit, that's not good. All right. It's all done. I loaded it up there. I put the narrative in there and everything. It's on YouTube, but it's hidden on YouTube. All right. I'll look at it tonight. Thanks for letting me know, Mike.
Sarah, correction was for breaking place. He knows, just really wanted to be at the door.
Yeah. So that's why even the correction should even be higher then. Yep. Next.
Riley, hey Jeff, any tips for keeping calm and not becoming frustrated with a stubborn dog just pushing your buttons?
Yeah, stop working the dog in the moment. Mm-hmm. Stop. Don't play with the dog. Don't work the dog. Kennel the dog back up and you reset. Absolutely don't work the dog. This is the way you look at it. Ready? You'll be a much better dog trainer, much better dog handler when you start learning how to communicate with this dog. Okay, it's the dog training universe that's saying to you, I'm going to make you a more patient human being. I'm going to make you a better dog trainer. And I'm going to teach you some new skills and some new things about yourself that you can't learn on your own. And the dog is going to help you do that. That's what you do. You get frustrated, stop working. Okay? And don't fake it till you make it. Literally, don't be frustrated or stop working. Next.
Nice. Redwood Reaver, any recommendations on muzzles?
Use them for biting dogs. Next.
I think they meant brand.
Brand? Oh, Baskerville and Jaffco. Baskerville is your most economical, and you can do food training. Mm-hmm. They can drink water. They can pant. It can be worn for long periods of time. Jaffco is a more secure muzzle, and they do have an opening. The breathing is not as good on that. And some condensate. It doesn't have as good airflow.
Yeah, next. Baskerville's the best.
But Baskerville is going to be your best. And it's available at all the big back stars. Jaffco is harder to get. It's also much more money. Next.
Daria. Hey, guys. I recently bought an e-collar mini educator after watching your videos. They helped a lot. So thank you for that. I did what your video showed about finding the working level. Tucker wasn't responding to anything until 8 to 10. But when I started doing recall introduction following the steps in your video, he got very scared of the corrections. His tail would tuck.
Okay.
And he'd slink down to the ground and slink his head. So okay. I laid off it for a while. Then I started using level 5 with recall, worked on a leash inside, and worked down to a 3. I use a level 3 outside and have it on continuous, and I have the boost at 10. Once I started introducing the recall and what I wanted, I started adding the command word Chodes, I don't know, pronounced like hoach. Okay. This is All right, there's more. Hold on.
Because it's already going on too long.
Which is Polish for come.
Okay.
He already knew it was a command, so it was more solid ground to build off of. Then he was understanding it and had his e-collar on when he went into my backyard. There are two psychotic dogs that live behind us.
Okay, stop. Stop. Okay. It's too long. The show is not for such long questions. So, Dario. The show, I can't have it keep going on. It's too.
Yeah,
there was still
like three or four.
It's parts no, of that. It's too long. This is not an exclusive thing here. Do a Patreon. Join my Patreon channel for those long things, or do a Skype. This is the thing. It shouldn't be correction. You shouldn't be correcting your dog on the remote to train an obedience command. All right, you're doing escape training, and it's at low level. So your levels were probably too high, and you need to do lots of leash work, food reward. Okay, food reward next. I'm sorry, I didn't want to cut you off, but that was going on way too long, and I've got a lot of flexibility with my questions here. Next.
Jorge, hi, my GSD won't react or chase cars when they go slow and close to her, but sometimes we'll try to chase them when far and at higher speeds.
That's the prey drive kicking in. So keep the dog out of long line. You can correct your dog out of that. You make it suck to chase cars. Did you do the one about from Jay Wynn? Any tips on building confidence?
That was my next one.
Oh, sorry.
Geez, any tips on building confidence on the walk?
Sorry, I thought you skipped that because there's so many from Daria there. what I want you to do is on confidence on the walk, if the dog's insecure, the best thing to do is just walk. Walk, keep the dog in a proper heel, walk by environmentals. Mm-hmm. Remote collar is going to help clear the dog's mind and not get it to scan and get nervous, believe it or not. Remote collar is great for nervous dogs on walks. Mm-hmm. Don't forget, you can hit the subscribe button and hit your bells. Next.
Hit your bells. Jenny, we recently rescued a GSD 1 year old. He's dog reactive and I have a prong on him, but when I correct him for not going after a dog, he will whine and yell and jump up and bite the leash.
Yep. That's all classic snotty behavior. We see that a lot as well. What I want to make sure your timing is good. Remember, there's an art to using any tool out there. There's an art to using any tool. What happens with a lot of leash reactivity dogs, so say the dog was on a flat buckle collar, a martingale, or a slip lead. What would happen is the dog would be able to pull, it would be the end of the leash, and it would be barking and being reactive. And you would just be holding on. That's what would happen. Now that you're using a tool that actually empower you and it can apply a consequence, what's happening is it's stopping the dog's physical movement, but its mental movement is still there. And what happens then? The dog, instead of moving forward, jumps up, jumps towards you, redirects on the leash and can redirect on you. The collar is not doing that. The fact that the dog can't do what it wants to do is doing that. So you work the dog through. That's where the skill set comes in, where you want to recognize the dog's about to be reactive right at the moment or prior to it being reactive. And that's when you get that dog. That's when you apply your correction for that. Don't wait until the dog's being reactive. It's too late. The dog's already loading. The dog's already ramping up. You might actually be adding fuel to the fire. So what you want to do is you want to squash that down immediately. If you miss it and the dog starts coming after you, you need a game plan for that as well. Next.
Stacy, I asked yesterday about my male GSD getting aroused hyper. He's making my husband and son uncomfortable. You suggested a down place away from me, which he does great. Do I correct high on the e-collar?
No. First of all, mm-hmm. what's even more important is the fact that there's two people in your house that are uncomfortable around this dog. Nobody should be uncomfortable around their family dog. Nobody. Now, we get dogs in that people they're uncomfortable with, but that's what our job is to do the training. But I'd sit down with everybody and I'd make sure you have a game plan and nobody should be in denial. And let's figure out why they're uncomfortable. I don't recall from yesterday if there's any aggression at all or not. But don't give a correction, a high-level correction on any obedience command until the dog knows it, which means you've done it hundreds of times successfully. The last thing I want anybody to be doing, I talk about punishment all day long, but the last thing I want anybody to be doing is giving a correction to a dog for obedience that doesn't know that command extremely well. Next.
Victoria, what I have found since discovering you, the best advice you have given for me is to stay calm and not be angry. When I worked on myself, my dogs began to respond and work. Thank you.
Exactly. I'm glad you picked up that message. I'm not in the dog training business, guys, believe it or not.
Garrett laid a foundation with my prong on my two pups, purchasing e-collars tomorrow. Been eating ramen and cans of tuna to save up. Can't wait. Any tips on running the two collars on a single remote?
Yeah, you just have to make sure that you remember which collar is on which dog. So you put the black one on one and the red one on the other at all times, and make sure you understand whose button is whose. They're marked black and red, so that'll be good. Also, tuna can get pricey. I want you to spend even less money on your food. And I want that ramen to be extended to two meals a day. Water it down. Come on. How bad do you want those fucking collars? Next. God. Isn't that, at least I didn't tell him to go scrounge for bugs on his floor and that could be his protein. Next.
Dog kibble. Jesus, how can I stop my dog from overhumping female dogs without the dressage whip? I can't get one.
Well, it's not overhumping. It's just humping in general.
Not even a little bit.
Why can't you get a dressage whip? Great. You have to apply a punisher. Take a leash. You take a leash, smack the dog's ass with a leash. That you can do. Can do that. Next.
Aliazzi. Oh, plenty for you to still do, Jeff. I need foundational tips.
All right. Good, Aliazzi.
Matt, cousin's dog bit their young kid while he was laying on the floor playing video games. I'm helping them find a real trainer. Any tips in the meantime? Have kids supply the dog with all meals or just keep them separated?
Okay. Without knowing the dog, the kid, the skill set of the family, keep them separated. That's the smart thing to do. I'm not going to endanger a child's life over a dog training, protocol. I won't do it. I won't do it. Next.
Jason, even first thing in the morning, he won't. And I actually tried peeing in front of him. The second I take the leash off, he'll go.
Fuck.
Oh, wait. He's moving to the city soon, so he's trying to prep him for that. He's great off-leash, but I'd rather not risk taking him out of that one in the city.
No, you can't. The dog needs to piss outside.
Wes held out for probably 2 days when I first moved.
I know. You hold out for longer. It's so unhealthy for these dogs, though. It's so unhealthy for these dogs. I would try to hold out for longer. It's a choice. I've known dogs that don't crap well. The only thing I can suggest is this. Bring the dog out like on a 12-foot line, 12-foot leash, drop it, and step on it. Give the dog a little bit of freedom. But gosh, I wouldn't do that. I would make sure that I would stand there and wait till that dog pissed. Bring him back in, put him in a crate, go back out, see if the dog will piss. Next.
New Zealand Kiwi. We have a 16-week-old pup who is inconsistent with his pee pad training. Sometimes he'll pee on it. Other times he'll tear it up and pee next to it. Or even pee in front of us with no qualms. Help.
So I can't help you because I don't do pee pad training. I've never done pee pad training at all. I don't know how to do it. I don't know how to fix your problem. We crate train and house break dogs. So I don't know. I actually don't know how to do that. So I would look for a trainer that knows how to do pee pad training. Look it up online. I imagine YouTube. There's got to be some good YouTube videos on that. Next.
Enlightened canine perspective. Thanks, Joel, for agreeing on how nervous you were coming to your first seminar. I'm coming to Providence in 2 weeks, and it's going to be hell getting the dog inside. He has bitten 12 people. When he's seen another dog and couldn't get to them because of a leash, I can't wait. Going to be a great weekend.
Awesome. Enlightened canine. Well, we'll have Joel help you with that dog. Yeah. So make sure the dog is muzzled. So muzzle that dog, and then we'll be okay. So if he's going to try to bite, let him try to bite me. Got it? Next. Oh, Top Chat, $5. Nadine. Oh, hey, Nadine. How are you? Remarkably more confident one-year-old lab, and thanks. She still growls and randomly tries to retreat while in place. Bonk the second she starts. Help. Growls and randomly tries to retreat while in place. What does she try to retreat to? The crate? I would use a remote collar for that. So keep the dog on a leash. You can actually put a leash on a tie back, which helps you contain the real estate that the dog has. And then I don't know what the growling or the retreating is. Sometimes I need more information on these questions. That's the hard part about some of these Q&As that I do. It's like, I need a lot more information than I'm getting. I'm just trying to think about what what the dog's retreating and what it means by the dog retreating, retreating into its crate, well, then it's not holding place so they can hold the dog accountable. I'd rather you do a leash prong correction than a bonker correction. Next.
Redwood Reaver. Any tips on teaching target urination, tree, hydrant, friend's foot, etc.?
It's not my skill set. I have no idea. I would talk to a trick trainer on that one. Next.
LSMK. Hi, my one-year-old staff. What?
No, no, I'm looking at you. I was really,
My one-year-old Staffy, who normally ignores other dogs, has massive problem with dogs who get in his face or run at me. I've muzzled him as I don't want him biting another dog. Any advice? Cheers.
Well, can you blame the dog? And let's think about this. You know, if a dog ran at me, and if a dog ran into my dog, got into my dog's face, my dogs wouldn't like it either, especially if they were on leash. 1 year old is a critical time. The dog's going into adulthood. So the more of the real dog is revealed. But I don't expect my dog. I mean, if we're gonna stand here and expect our dogs to put up with dogs getting in their face, I think that's a disaster waiting to happen. Dogs rushing at us. I don't expect most dogs to be able to just sit there and hang out. So the more they see us take care of it, the better. So don't let dogs get in its face, especially when the dog's on leash. That's a dangerous thing because then dog gets a little bit nervous, concerned. It can't go anywhere. It can't move around because it's on a leash. So what does it do? Usually growl and lunge. I don't let dogs come up to my dogs. I don't interact with unknown dogs. So, you know, what you're seeing is normal now. So let's start advocating more for your dog. Next.
Monique, my dog pops his lipstick whenever he gets excited. How do I stop the lipstick pop?
I don't know. Stop walking around topless. I mean, you know, I don't know how to stop that. I mean, I don't think anybody can stop me from popping my lipstick. You know what I mean? So, I mean, I guess I lived in a nunnery, but even then some of those nuns are looking pretty hot these days. Oh, so I don't know. That's not something we do. I've got no idea.
Just let it hang out.
No. I mean, I wouldn't know what to do.
West does sometimes.
Yeah.
Aaron, ding, stepped away for a minute and missed your answer, but I'll catch the podcast. Thanks so much for all you guys do. Dog with separation anxiety is now obedient, keeps place at home so much better.
Awesome.
Tropical tails. So many people say GSC can pick up when you're depressed and anxious, and they will become depressed and anxious. What do you think? Is this true?
I have no idea. Next.
Kinsey, not dog related, but I have a question for Joelle. I just started following you on IG, so inspired by your fitness. I started lifting a bit ago. Love it. What is your training protocol? It's too long to answer on here. DM me.
Yeah, DM Joelle. But she also does it for work too. She'll put a plan of action together for you. Yep. Next.
Nia, how do you feel about all the doodle breeds? I'm finding a lot of them have terrible temperaments.
No opinion. I mean, they'll keep bringing them to us. I mean, I think a lot of dogs in general have got terrible temperament now. A lot of them. I don't think it's a doodle issue. I think it's a 2019 dog issue. So,
top chat. And thanks, Kinsey. That was nice of you.
Least I can do for all your help and support. Thanks so much. That's from C. Rixis. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Rixis.
Shana. At the Mantua seminar, will you be discussing business models? I need to learn how to screen my clients better. I get most of them from online.
I don't do a lot of that. It's geared more towards dog owners, even though it's about 25% dog trainers. I might dabble on that. You can set up a private consult with me, though. So you can always set up a private consult with me. So you want to email me, and there's a fee for that. And also you can do a Skype with me. I mean, that's actually how I make a living. So I do so much free stuff, but you know, that's one of my paid services, is business consulting. Next.
Crescent Moon Girl. Hi, Jeff. My dog is toy aggressive. I've been correcting, but now he starts to attack and snap at my Dane when walking by. I took away toys, but feel bad playing with Dane when he can't. How to make him calm?
Well, don't feel bad. Well, I can't tell not someone to feel bad about it, but I mean, the dog's behavior doesn't warrant playing with him. So what I would do is you put him in place, you put him in down. You can teach him the out command, which means get out of here. That's done on a remote collar. You should be able to play with your Dane as much as you want. So we have to realize that we've got more control over our dogs than we think we do. We actually can, you know, tell them what to do, and we can actually hold them accountable. We can change their behaviors. So what I would do is the concept is go mind your own business. I'll do what I want with my other dog, and you've got to go lie down and mind your business. So that's the philosophy. So how do we get that down or place? And you hold them to it while you interact with your Great Dane, or you teach them, and or you actually you teach them the out command, which means, you know, get out of here.
Top chat
499. Zach, hello. I was looking for clarification. You told me I shouldn't let my new dog meet for a few days. Does that mean they can be in the same room? No, they can be in the same room, guys. There could be. I'm a huge advocate of existence. You can have 20 dogs in the same room all lying down that never theoretically meet each other. I mean, you can't have them staring, glaring at each other, but they absolutely can be in the same room. All our board and train dogs are in the same room. They rarely meet each other. They're actually right next to each other, all lined up. So, next.
Dana Walters. Hi, guys.
Hey.
Hey, Dana.
That's it? Oh, hey, Dana. Sorry, I thought there was a question.
No. Shayna, by the way, I completely understand when you say if anyone messes with your family, you will kill them. But if anyone messes with Angelo, I'm right behind you with my Italian frying pan game on.
thanks, Shayna. So,
oh, I love it.
So, Angelo. Linda is going to beat you to it. So you'll like there won't be anything left. All right, we'll let you bury the body. So
get rid of the evidence.
So my wife's Italian, and my wife's from New England. And I'll let you guys put the pieces together. All right. So she's born and bred here. Her family's from here. Her family came over from Italy. So she's Italian. So you definitely don't want to mess with any of our kids. You know, me, she doesn't give a shit. She'll be like, you didn't take the guy. He's got $1 million in life insurance. But definitely don't want to mess with our kids. So. It's good to know that I got somebody in my back on that one.
Juliana, what advice could you give me to get my bull mastiff puppy on the right path to a well-behaved adult dog? Or which videos or of yours do you suggest I watch? Love your unadulterated honesty. Unadulterated.
Does that mean X-rated? Does that mean like...
I have no idea.
Like X-rated humor?
I guess.
So, Juliana, thank you for joining the show. So, what I would do is this. Start with the basics. Start with the do-it-yourself. This is what I want you to do. Road to success. Massive structure, not as much affection. Lots of engagement. The reward is the interaction through play and training. Crate your dog in and out on command. Do threshold training. Work on sit, down, place, and recall. We food train all those commands. Eventually, after hundreds of reps of doing it successfully, hold the dog accountable. Don't be picking up this dog. It's going to be huge when it gets older. Cut down on your affection. Don't use too many words on any of your commands. Be very clear and concise with the work you do. Don't muck it up with too many words. Dog training is simple. You dictate all the engagement stuff. You say when we play, you say when we stop play. Sleep in a crate when you're not home. Get the dog exposed to as many different environmentals as possible, not just people, sounds, and surfaces. Next.
Amber, my dog is fear aggressive towards other dogs, but with the e-collar, he's very submissive and doesn't react to other dogs. Is it okay to bring him to a dog park to counter condition?
Never, ever, guys, I hate dog parks. I hate them. So I can't tell you to bring your dog to a dog park. Now, the outside of a dog park and use that as a distraction, hell yeah. I would never go to a dog park. So I can't tell you, I can't give you the advice to do it. Now, I'm not against your dog playing with other dogs. Find your own play group, though. Find your own play group. Next.
Ken, interesting answer. Thanks.
I don't know. What was the answer?
I don't know.
Oh, cool.
Your answers are interesting.
I don't know. Ken, are you being sarcastic?
Probably.
Probably. I know.
Scoo, 5805. Hey, Jeff, I have a 1.5-year-old dog who is leash reactive around other dogs. I don't see many old many dogs on our, I don't know where I got old from. Oh, the line above it. I don't see many dogs in our walks. Would you recommend training at a distance in a dog park as a substitute?
There you go. The outside of a dog park, use the dogs on the inside of the dog park. So Ken, if you're being sarcastic, just keep in mind that some of my answers are also sarcastic and I have fun on this show. But some of my stuff is non-traditional and it's actually like my philosophy. So we have to tell people, I just don't remember the question. So people always have to follow the body of work that we do. Next.
Eric, my outside dogs won't stop barking at everything. Any help?
Yep. Get yourself a bark collar. Get yourself a Garmin bark limiter or a e-collar technology bark collar. Sport dog makes a decent bark collar. Dog trim makes a decent bark collar. That's going to be your easiest, simplest, most effective, best time solution. Next.
Lil Mama Mud. Hello, A.
Hey, what's up there?
Hey, Canada.
Haven't heard from you in a while.
Lakey. Dealing with a leash reactive puppy. He just bolts at everything. I have him on a nylon kind of choke chain. The nylon part is the choker. Hence why I asked the previous prong collar question. Tips?
I don't know how old the dog is. Yeah, I mean, if the dog is being reactive, time for a prong collar. There you go. Next.
Carrie, GSD lover. Hey, Jeff and Joelle, my nine-month-old GSD is getting extremely aroused and then pees on my husband only.
What?
Whoa. We set him up doing it, and I do a firm leash pop, and he stops, but next time he goes right back.
How the fuck could your
dog? I've done it about 50 times. Not enough.
Carrie.
No.
Carrie, you're a regular follower. You've been on this show before. Mm-hmm. When did this all hard? Why have we, this is news to me. Your dog is pissed on your husband 50 times. That's disgusting. Why is that not your ex-husband? Like, are you serious?
That's crazy.
That's beyond crazy. What is going on?
Oh, Jeff's talking in his high-pitched voice, Carrie. What?
Carrie, why have we never heard about this? I'm amazed. I'm blown away that you own a dog that's pissed on your husband 50 times. How is this happening? Where's your husband? Where's the dog?
Does he just lift his leg on him?
Yeah, I would. God, if I had a dog that pissed on somebody, boy, would it 50 once? Maybe. But more than once?
50 freaking times. You should have said that.
50 fucking times? What are you, crazy? 50 times. 50 times. What is the dog doing? Walking up to your husband and lifting its leg? What's your husband do?
Well, let me scroll down and see if she's answering. Proofed it 50 times, she says.
Okay. All I know is this. If a dog was to piss on someone, they would get an incredibly high-level correction. Remote collar. Act of God. Next.
All right. Well, now I got to find it because I scrolled all the way down. Okay. There we are. Beverly. After a traumatic incident, one's friendly dog snaps at anyone who gets too close. Suggestions?
Yeah. What I would do right now is dog on a leash. Get the dog around lots and lots of people. Don't have people interact at all. Start recognizing the signs that the dog is starting to get aroused. Correct the arousal. That's for starters to do that. Will the dog ever accept people? That's a whole other protocol. Next.
Sarah, thank you for the advice. I super appreciate the help and guidance.
You're welcome.
Deanna, Pitbull is fine with most volunteers at shelter, but will charge and bite most people he doesn't know. Drooled excessively early on when he first came in.
So the thing about the shelter is you've got a lot of transitional people. It's not consistent. Everybody's giving the dog a different message. They're not correcting dogs there for unwanted behavior historically. Excuse me, way too much arousal, way too much love and affection. I usually don't work with dogs at the actual shelter because unfortunately it won't be successful because there's too many chefs in the kitchen. And it's not a pit bull conversation, it's a dog conversation. Charge and bite most people he doesn't know. I mean, he's not adoptable at this rate, right? He's not adoptable at this rate. Dog needs to come out of the shelter to be rehabbed and see what we get. I mean, there's not much advice you can give for a dog that's living in a shelter that it doesn't have consistent. It needs a very consistent, day. So next.
Haley, hi, Jeff. I'm training a Belgian Malinois, and any tips on how to help focus and engagement?
Yeah, I mean, it's a Belgian Malinois. Malinois should be hyper-focused on you with a ball, at least. I would look for a sport dog trainer. Find yourself, if you want a Malinois, you want to probably eventually get into sport, even if it's just for fun. So I would start looking at sport dog videos on YouTube. Sport dog videos on YouTube. There's videos specifically for building up engagement. That's what I would do. But if you want a Mal, get some professional help.
Type chat
from BK. Dog parks scare the freaking fuck out of me after I had to pull an 80-pound bully breed off my golden retriever who was minding his own business. So dangerous. Yep. That's why I don't like them. $10. Carrie, GST Levers. Sorry, guys. I was so embarrassed. I feel like we should have it under control with all your videos and success, but he just started doing it. Oh, like none of my...
embarrassed.
Don't be... Carrie, none of my videos prevent dogs from fucking pissing on husbands. Well, maybe they do because nobody's ever asked me that one before. So I guess they do. That's one more thing we can say they do. Watch my videos. Your dog won't piss on your husband.
Piss on your husband. Unless you want it to.
I would correct that dog super high if it did that again. How high? So high the dog would be afraid to piss for a while, I would imagine. That's the downfall actually of correcting a dog pissing inside. You can actually think it's getting corrected for peeing or peeing in front of you. But oh my god, excuse me. All this talk about piss is getting me tired. I would absolutely correct my dog extremely high if I caught my dog pissing on another human being. Next.
Yeah. Shana, forgive me for asking so many questions. I have one more that I told you about before. Did consult with guy that keeps hitting on me. So I told him I'm booked till April, but he just texted me again yesterday. Help.
Shana, are you fucking kidding me? Are you kidding me? Shana.
Block.
You're a grown-ass woman. You don't know how to go tell someone to go fuck themselves?
Ban and delete.
It's really simple. So email them a letter. I'm sure you have your email if it's a client of yours. Because of your unprofessional behavior, I can no longer work with you. Do not contact me again. Or call them up and say, if you fucking text me, I'll come over and cut you. Take your pick. Come on. You got to stop it. Anything but that is fucking flirting. Dudes can be stupid about this stuff. You have to let them know it's unacceptable. No, don't contact me again. This is not what I do. It's over. Next.
Many methods dog training. LOL, Jeff, love the humor.
Oh. Since when am I... what kind of fucking humor?
Okay.
Thanks.
He's actually dead serious, you guys. Right. God. Zachary, my dog is under voice...
Why do people find this funny? I'm being serious.
Okay. Oh my God, you guys are insulting him.
What are you saying? I'm a joke?
Zach's dog is under voice control. Sometimes he lets out a bark along with obeying the command, like he's frustrated doing it. How do I correct this without confusing him when he's obeying the command?
Makes me think of the movie Goodfellas. Did you ever see Goodfellas? What do you mean by funny? What are you trying to say? Like you think I'm here to humor you?
Good impression.
Oh, God.
Can you answer the damn question?
So the bark could be excitement. Like every once in a while we'll get a drivey working dog that'll bark while it's doing obedience because it's just so excited to work. It could be frustrated, but that's a touchy one, man. You got to be careful. It's like, do we stop? I mean, I don't want dogs barking at me though. I would probably stop the bark. I'd probably stop the dog. I would probably slow down everything. Next.
Crescent Moon Girl. Hi, one more question. My 6-month-old Dane got super excited when he came home from outside and acts like he loses his mind. He has an e-collar. Would it be fair to give a small tap to remind him to stay calm?
Yeah, or bonk him. The dog's aroused. Eliminate the arousal. Next.
Juan, hi Jeff and Joelle. Walked my 8-month-old pup the other night when it was windy. Lots of trees blowing, leaves and crap blowing in the street. Pup was super high alert and couldn't get him to settle into a heel. Any tips for getting a dog to settle down in an uncomfortable environment?
Yeah, I don't blame him. That's going to be a rough one sometimes. So I would do some 180s, watch my video on 180s, do a bunch of directional turns, get the dog focused on the work. Next.
Zach, hi guys, hopping on late. I know the bonker is supposed to be thrown. So what is the correct way to bonk if the dog is right next to me? Her head is hip height.
No, it doesn't get thrown. I mean, I prefer to use a bonker with a dog right there. Mm-hmm. Right there. No, boom. I show it right in the video. Watch my video. Right there. That's how I want to be used. The closer you are, the better. Closer you are, the better. Mm-hmm. Next.
Yep. Ellie. Found your channel last year, used prong to start, then transitioned to e-collar. Now I rarely use e-collar corrections, and my dog listens even with big distractions in front of her. Thank you. Thankful for y'all.
Awesome, Ellie. Nice.
New Zealand Kiwi, thank you. So what's the next best step to transition our pup to be housebroken without pee pads?
Well, what you have to do is fade away the pee pads, which you want to – thank you. That's a question I can answer. Also, by the way, I love New Zealand. I'm trying to schedule an Australian seminar. I was there once before. It was great. We had about 95 people. It was a great seminar. New Zealand, I've got some great connections over in New Zealand as well. What I want you to do is dogs on a schedule. Crate train first. Schedule. Housebreaking. No free roaming. Take your dog out on a schedule. Your eyes are always on your dog. You never have that dog out of your sight. Start working on duration place. No free roaming at all. The big thing is dog on a leash. Go out the same door. Go to an area outside. The dog urinates or defecates. Click and reward. Next.
Nadine, she tries to come to me or under couch. I'm not sure what causes the behavior, but we'll use prong and remote.
Got it. That's the fleeing. Okay. So, correct the dog. Make sure it stays on place. Next.
Many methods dog training. Hey, Jeff, I'm putting out as much video content as possible, but I'm worried about putting out too much that people won't need to hire me. Thoughts? I want people to be completely aware of what I do beforehand and see the progress, not just the before and after. Of course, thanks. I'll sure to DM you. And oh, wait, that's a different person.
Okay.
Sorry.
So many methods dog training. Have you seen the amount of content I put out? Have you seen the amount of free stuff I put out? I have videos you can train a green dog to fully off-leash train. My free advice can rehab aggression. You can fix jumping, counter surfing, fence fighting, resource guarding. You can understand how dogs interact with each other, how to socialize two dogs. Massive amounts of free advice I give out with no expectation of anything to gain at all. And I don't think I put out enough. I don't think I'm working hard enough to put enough stuff out. I do 24 seminars around the world. Every one of them is sold out. Dollar-wise, it's humongous. I've got a successful boarding train in Providence, Rhode Island, with a wait list from dogs coming in from everywhere. California, Alaska, Canada. This is not ego stuff. I'm not bragging here. I turn away 50% of the business, not because we're busy, because I don't think they're the right clients for us, that we'll have a win-win. Not because of the dog's behavior. We can rehab just about any dog. I just don't think it's the right client for us. I'm looking for the perfect match. I want everybody to win. I don't want to just take money, do the job, and then give the dog back to the client. I want them to be successful. In order to do that, we pre-screen our clients. I'm still busy. I still feel I don't put enough free content out. Mm. Got it? People will always need you. They'll always need you. You can show me how to paint my house. You can show me every tip, every trick, the brush stroke, everything. I will pay somebody to paint my house. I pay somebody to rake my leaves. Okay? I know how to rake leaves. My time is better spent not raking leaves. I'd rather produce content. Now, yes, I do rake some leaves because I do it with the kids and it's a great time. But spring cleanup, fall cleanup, major stuff, I hire a company. Cutting shrubs, I got all the equipment in my shed. Someone else does it for me. I'm not a wealthy man. I just prioritize my time. The number one way to make a really good revenue is by saving people time. Anybody out there that's not making a decent living, it's probably because you're either lazy or you've got your skill sets are not up to par. Because I can show you how to make $25 an hour real quick. How? Run errands for people that are busy. Save people time. Got it? You will always be needed. Now, who are you as a human being? What's your dog training skills? That's what you need to focus on. Giving away free stuff, that's not going to destroy your business. Next.
Ooh, right. Kinsey, of course, thanks. I'll be sure to DM you. And thanks to Jeff as well. Love watching your videos. Always something new to learn.
Yeah, that's DMU. That's yeah. DMU. Yep.
Sammy, you said that martingale collars like choke chains. I was always told that they don't, that it has a stopping point and goes around the whole circumference of the neck. Explain, please.
I agree. It does. It's called a limited, Sammy, it's a limited choke. It's a limited choke. The way that a martingale collar works is by putting compression on the dog's neck. It is choking the dog. Now, does it choke like a choke chain? No, it does not. It's a limited choke. Can you kill a dog with one? Yes, you can. How? By it would choke. It would suffocate. It's really hard to choke a dog out with a prong collar. Okay, next.
Max Asina, why are you buffering so much tonight?
I've been working out. Thanks for the compliment. I don't know. I don't think I'm buffering. You're the first one to mention it. It could be your connection. It could be mine. Maybe the replay will be better. Next.
Yeah, Melissa said it might be his connection.
Okay.
Amanda B. Hey, Jeff, what's the best way to transfer from a prong to a martingale? We can't use anything but a flat, which will transfer to after the martingale.
Right, we're CGC.
We're CGC, so we need off the prong. Thanks as always.
Oh, fucking CGC. CGC is a goddamn joke. It doesn't mean shit, but I understand why you want to do it. You know, I'm not insulting you, even though it probably sounded like it. Talk to your CGC trainer. The CGC is just a test. It's a 15-minute whatever moment in time that's if your dog's under voice control, it should be able to do it. It's a test. So you can use all the tools to study for the test. Now it's time for you to do the test. So you go tool free. Next.
Amber. My dog whines a lot. I don't give positive or negative attention. I try to do the two-finger jab, but it makes it worse. And I tried to correct with the e-collar, but it doesn't make a difference.
Well, that is negative attention. It's a punishment. It's a punishment. The dog whining, I would always say check out for injuries or health, but it's probably not that. It's probably just a lot of anxiety. You know, you can bonk the dog, more duration work. People say, oh, tire the dog more out more. Trust me, we've had dogs that whine. No matter how tired you get them, they still whine. Okay, they whine constantly. They whine in their sleep. You know, what's that dog's name?
Apollo.
No, the Doberman.
Oh, Hank.
Hank, yeah. We've had some really challenging dogs sometimes that whine. I think Roxy was a whiner too. But most dogs you can stop from whining. Next.
Chelsea, don't feel bad, Carrie. One time my dog marked on my sleeping mother, LOL.
Well, I don't see a problem with that. Next.
Todd, evening.
Hey, good evening. How are you, Todd?
Tommy, thanks for the advice about understanding each dog's ability. My newer dog is much slower than other dogs and very skittish.
Yeah.
Now I'm trying to let him be successful and minimize fails for his confidence.
That's smart. But eventually, set the dog up for failure. Got it? A lot of people are like, set the dog up for success. It's like, you're right. I agree. At some point, set the dog up for failure and work the dog through it. But Yeah, dogs have caps. They've got caps, meaning certain dogs are only going to do certain things. I mean, I've got four German Shepherds that all got different abilities. I have three. Do I have three or four?
Three.
I have three now. Three German Shepherds and a Malinois. They all have different abilities. Next.
Anne Berlin. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Love you guys. Thanks for the work you do.
Oh, thanks, Amber.
Juliana, if you're ever in my neck of the woods, McAllen, Texas, we'd love to have you over for a Texas-sized barbecue. We are madly in love with you.
Hey, man, Juliana.
Jeff never turns down barbecue.
I'll have a Rhode Island-sized freaking barbecue at this point. Actually, that's what's – I was just in Texas. I'll be in Austin in November. I've got a seminar, jeffgellmanseminars.com, and there's two good barbecue places right by where I'm staying that I think Sonny's is there. And is it Sonny's or Rudy's? There's two good places there, though. Next.
Carrie, GSD lover. Super High is a very firm leash pop. Seriously, is the Skype just about pee? I'm embarrassed, so maybe better to do a quick one.
We're doing a Skype, and I'm recording it, and I'm putting it out. Leash pop isn't enough. Remote collar. Next.
Zach, by the way, Jeff, you are definitely humorous. That's why I listen to a podcast every day. Entertainment value, dog training, and life lessons.
Thanks, Zach. I appreciate it.
Carrie, GSD lover. I feel like we were doing really well and totally upped the structure at a loss.
Check for a UTI, but it's probably not that. I mean, I don't know. What's going on with you and your husband? Like, what's going on with you and your husband? Everything okay? You don't have to answer this publicly. Everything okay? I mean, even if you're having problems, that's no reason for the dog to piss on him. But what's changed? Like, what's changed? Next.
Student of Life's Lessons. Just found your channel. I have a Carolina Dingo that I'm trying to make my service dog. He's doing well, but having trouble getting him to stop barking at anything that's outside of our window.
Okay, so the dog might not be – just remember – so thank you for finding me. All dogs are not made for service dogs. Most dogs are bred for service dog work, and even those dogs, there's about a 50% washout. I don't know what the tasks the dog will be doing. I don't know what your skill set is, but most dogs can't be service dogs. But on that note, because I just want you to make a dog a service dog that can't be a service dog, and you jeopardize the safety of somebody else, including yourself. Getting a dog to stop barking is easy, though. A remote collar, which is a shock collar. No, correct. Dog stops barking. Next.
Shane, do you come across dogs that you can't train? If so, what is the protocol, such as return of money?
No, there's no return. There's no returning of money. No, because every dog we make better. Every dog we make better. And if you're working with a dog that you can't train, I mean, if you literally can't train it because it's above your skill set, well, that's a different story. But there's dogs aren't coming in that are above our skill sets. Now, if we get a dog that we don't get to the expectation that we want to, we knew that would might happen before the dog came in. So we already had that conversation with the owner. So we always want to establish reasonable levels of expectation before there's any agreement whatsoever. So if you've got a dog that gets into dog fights and the owner says, well, we want to take him to a dog park. And if you say, sure, I can do that. And then the dog goes to a dog park and fights. Well, now that's just being foolish, right? Now it's being foolish. So there has to be a level of expectation that's established. Since we work with a lot of aggressive dogs, though, the level of expectation is an unknown until you start working the dog. And then after the board and train, there's a knowledgeable conversation that's given to the owners about what the dog is capable of in that moment, in that time of its life, and then what to do to make it better.
Two top chats.
$4.99 from Zach. And this is live. You said, whoa, when Joel read that I got an Akbash, is that something to tell? Is that supposed to tell me something? No.
Next.
I mean, I was impressed that she said Akbash. Brandon Miller, do your dogs react to you when you say commands as you explain them on here? No, they don't. Nope. My dog, because I'll say break, They don't move. Sit, down, place. They don't move. I'll take a bonker, hold the bonker up. They don't move. They know I'm not talking to them. I believe dogs are situational, it's contextual. So yeah, they're not here right now. I actually took them down to my work because I'm leaving for New Orleans. Joelle's going to take care of them. When I travel, she takes care of them if they don't go with me.
Next. Amber, how can I get my 11-month-old doodle to stop gleeping? We practice place and four on the floor when greeting people, and even though he calms down, he's still happy peas. P.S. Thank you for sharing all of your wisdom.
Gleeping?
Gleeping.
What the fuck?
Gleep. That's funny.
Is that like, what's this, happy hands or what's this, what do they call
spirit
this?
Spirit fingers.
Spirit fingers? That's the first thing I thought of when she said gleeping. Spirit fingers. Who the fuck calls it gleeping?
I think it's funny.
Okay.
How do you stop it?
Okay. This is what we do. We actually don't let our dogs meet people then. That sounds mean. No. What you need to do is you need to start retraining these dogs' arousal. We put a dog through our training protocol, which is obedience, state of mind, holding the dog accountable, not a lot of affection. Even with four on the floor and people meeting the dog, that's still too exciting for the dog. So what you would do is you would do a bunch of that. And then when people meet, what are you doing? Starting your car?
It's snowing really bad. I need to make sure that.
Don't we have to record more AMA after this?
Yes, but I'm going to start it like 5 times before I leave. There's a lot of snow out there.
5 times? Isn't that a waste?
No, not that if I don't have to clean my windshield off. It's not.
Are your wipers on?
No, but the frost will melt it. Hopefully.
Have you thought about just brushing it off?
I didn't even wear boots. I'm like not dressed.
I'll
for
go
this.
Out there and I'll do it.
Okay, great.
I'll do it. All right. So we do four on the floor. Just this, the excitement though is the people meeting it. So right now, put a kibosh on that for a little bit. Next.
Lake puppy is 4 months old, e-collar and or prong collar. How long is too long in a crate for him?
16 weeks old. I mean, well. 16 weeks old, 4 months, 5 hours, probably 6-7 hours you're pushing it. Next.
Haley, Jeff, I recommend you to everyone I know use prong and e-collar with both of my dogs. Life changer.
Haley, be careful. You might lose some friends.
Yeah.
Be careful who you recommend.
You might lose a husband. You might. You might lose a lot of people. I'm just kidding.
Well, you're not, though.
It's the best.
Joelle lost her husband after she met me. And there was nothing going on with us.
No.
There's nothing going on. Yeah.
I was just miserable.
Yeah, yeah. You met
and
me.
You called me on it.
You met me, and like within a month, he asked for a divorce.
Next month makes a year.
If anybody wants to leave their husband. Go to one of my seminars. Okay? Start watching my videos first and talk about me. Go to one of my seminars and then start an internship with me. And within 1 month.
And go to T3.
Go to T3. And within a month, your husband will be like, I don't want any more of this.
You are way too empowered.
And you don't have to do a damn thing.
All right.
Next.
Maxicina. Yes, I tried that. I do not know why this is happening tonight. It is terrible.
Yeah, I don't know why. Next.
The March on 18. Hey, Jeff, we have a dog that will pee out of fear when we have any men over that the dog doesn't know. Have tried placing, but she always pees the bed. Any recommendations? We don't force interaction.
Well, you're doing everything right. So March on 18, you're doing everything right. Place, no interactions with other people. That's a hard one, man. That's a really, really hard one. And the dog's pissing lying down, which is a skill set all on its own. We would do place with at a distance. Okay, what happens if the dog's, oh my gosh, what happens if the dog's in a crate? Does that help? We would do dogs place at a distance, short periods of time, remove the dog from the room, and then bring back out more time. We would work up the time.
Next. Mike, dog sometimes starts to take off running, jolts forward while I'm prong during a structured walk. I firm correct with prong and e-collar, and she still does this sometimes. Thanks for the help.
You have to catch the dog prior to it wanting to bolt. You have to, so pay attention to the arousal. Keep the dog in heel. The dog should be behind your left leg, keeping the dog calm. And that's, it's the state of mind. It's the state of mind. A lot of people, what they're doing is the dogs are next to them. The dog's still a little bit aroused and the dog is a little bit flighty and it's scanning. The goal is to stop all that by having the dog walk a little bit behind you. Next.
Lauren, I have a dog that has to be dragged into his crate and one ever he shakes like a leaf. What should I do? He doesn't whine or bark.
What we can do is we've got a very specific crate protocol. You can actually add clicker and food to it. You should only have to quote unquote drag your dog in there a couple of times and then the dog will be go in there willingly. A lot of people say, oh, well, make it more enticing, throw food in there. The dog that doesn't want to go in his crate, that doesn't work. But it's the, you got to make sure you release the pressure when you're going forward with the leash. So you're having the dog go towards the crate. As soon as the front two paws go in the crate, you release pressure, see what happens. You can actually push a little bit from the back, have the dog come out, keep doing that back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Next.
Amanda B. Yes. Being a service dog, it's safer for us to have it. If anything, it was ever to come up. Plus it's not required to have CGC, but it's one of those most handlers try to have.
Got it. I understand. Cool. Next.
Amber, not a question, but I love how you were into raw feeding.
Thanks, Amber.
Haley, on walks, I try to heel both dogs on the right. One always tries to go behind me into my left. I use pressure to bring back to the right side, but she ends up behind. Okay. If not ahead of me in scanning.
Yep. Fine with me. Next.
Student of life's lessons. Can I make him stop barking without shock collars? I've been able to make him bow and stay with treats on his paws. Work hand commands, just the window is his only problem area. I've never hit or shock.
Okay.
He's only two.
So student of life, you're okay. First of all, hit and shock are not even in the same category. Got it? They're not even in the same category. Don't imply abuse. Do not imply abuse, not on my show. Okay? So we teach dogs, so we do trick training. So we have, so our trick trainer has the capability of training a dog probably up to 50 commands. 50. It's all done with food and clickers. Got it? We're food trainers. To stop an unwanted behavior, though, you're looking to correct, punish, extinguish an unwanted behavior and a behavior that's a pain in the ass, frankly. And obnoxious. The only way to stop it is by the delivering of proper punishment. Now you can teach your dog to be quiet and click and reward, but guess what your dog is going to do? It's probably going to bark more. But don't put hit and shock in the same category because it's two different things. A shock collar is not abusive. A shock collar is not mean at all. A shock collar saves dog's life. You can stop it any way you want to. Use a bonker. It's a cotton towel. It costs you a dollar. I've got a video on how to make it. The dog is barking in the window. Walk up to the dog. Say no. Throw this at the dog. Yep. You're hitting the dog in the head by tossing it at the dog's head. It startles the dog. But you might find that possibly mean. And I'm not going to convince you that it's not, if that's how you feel. But if you want to stop an unwanted behavior, you have to learn to properly apply punishment and feel really good about it. Because if you, this is the one that has, you have the service dog, what are you going to do when your dog, you can't proof your dog on a command? Right? What happens when you're walking your dog that's a service dog and it lunges at a child? You need to know how to properly stop an unwanted behavior. The only way you can do that is through punishment. Service dogs are expected to have an extremely high level of obedience training. Every single good service dog has been used punishment in its training. If they haven't, you're being lied to. Or else they can't be proofed. Teaching a trick has got nothing to do with the work we do. So I'm not mad either. Extreme clarification though. Next.
Amber, got it. Thank you. Learning how to retrain myself as well.
Great.
Zach, please do Joe Rogan's podcast. He loves Joe Rogan.
So I like Joe. I watch every one of his podcasts.
Imagine if you were on there. Oh, we can set that up.
I actually messaged him because I want to send Olivia one of his knives. Ooh. Just because he's a hunter. I wanted Olivia to send him his knife.
That would be such a great podcast. Yep. Haley, dying laughing. Glad you can laugh about it, Joel. It's all you can do, Haley. Just laugh about it.
Yep.
Russ says, haha, how many T3 divorces do you have now?
I think we're up to... There's been more since you. We might be up to 20. That we're not proud of it. I think we're up to about 20. About 20. Anyways, guys, it's the end of the show.
Oh, yep.
End of the show. Sorry. All right, guys. Sorry we couldn't get to we couldn't get to all the questions. I'm heading to New Orleans tomorrow. You'll be able to document it. Instagram stories. If you're not on our Instagram channel, jump onto our Instagram channel. Because you see a lot of behind the scenes stuff. You see my daily life on Instagram. Literally, when I get up at 4, I'm Instagramming. So it's like you see everything. And whenever I travel in my RV, I'm actually buying a new RV it's in New Orleans now. I'm picking it up. I'll be seeing Sean and Marta down there, most likely. I'm going to probably see Joseph James down there as well from Pro Canine Solutions. Let's see. And then on the way up, I'm stopping at my daughter Olivia's house. Olivia's the knife maker from Wildcraft Knives. She pounds steel all day. I'm going with one of my daughters, Romy. So the two of us are flying down there. And then you'll see a lot of, it'll be a fun trip. So definitely want to jump onto Instagram and then also follow all of our social media platforms to learn all kinds of great shit about dog training. The show will not be on most likely for a week. It'll be another 1 week hiatus. All right. So, but in the meantime, Joelle's going to be putting up plenty of content up there. And we've got 500 shows that you can go back to and watch and lots of great videos. All right. Madly in love with you guys. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscription, hit the notification because we're just putting up lots of great content. All right. Love you. Take care. Bye-bye.